Donnell Cooley was born in Grand, Oklahoma, just a small burg out in western Oklahoma. He was born into a family of fiddlers. He took up the instrument, whether he wanted to or not, I'm not sure, but he did. Eventually becoming a very accomplished music arranger and fiddler. Although in Tulsa, we know that Bob Wills is the king of Western swing. Spade Cooley claimed to be the king of Western swing. His family moved to Oregon, then down to Modesto, California, and they worked in the farms and the fields, and he played cards at night and played fiddle at night, and he said he wasn't going to be working in a bean field all his life, and he felt like he should go to Hollywood and be in TVs and movies and that sort of business. Radio, he thought radio would be good for him. One night in Modesto, California, playing poker with the usual cronies, he won three hands in a row with spade flushes. As a result, Donnell Cooley became Spade Cooley, and it's stuck ever since. He moved to Hollywood, in fact, was very popular there, had TV shows.
The Spade Cooley Show, presented by KTLA Television. And now here's your fiddling friend and mine, Spade Cooley!
Roy Rogers was his buddy. He let Roy and his wife take his yacht out for fishing trips. He was a celebrity. And this is a hard number to digest. But in the 50s now, he was making, in today's dollars, $120,000 a week. A week. He had 100 cowboy suits, 50 pair of boots, who knows how many hats, and a few too many women on the side, actually. He moved his wife, Ella May, who had been in his band for a while, out into the desert, California desert, after she had two children. Spade Cooley becomes the star of film and TV and radio. In fact, on his TV show, one of his frequent guests was Ronald Reagan. Established a great relationship with Ronald Reagan. Unfortunately, he started boozing. And boozing a lot. Then the booze became booze and pills. His loudmouth intimidation became physical abuse of lots of people. He could hire and fire in a heartbeat, and he was hard on his wife in a very bad way. He eventually lost all of his jobs, had $15 million in the bank. Man, that's a lot in the late 50s. Or any time, but especially then. He moved out into the desert. Disneyland had just opened. He thought, I can do a thing called Water Wonderland. I can do the same thing, and I'm going to start my own doggone TV studio out there, and I'm going to run it just the way I want. And I'm going to be able to keep my wife out there because I'm pretty sure she's fooling around. I'm pretty sure. Couldn't prove it. Didn't know it. Became jealous. Drunk. Uppers in the morning. Downers at night. They were both doing it. He would just beat her up, do awful, awful things, so bad that, in fact, she sent the two kids away for a while and then brought them back. They tried to kiss and make up a number of times. They knew that was not going to happen at all. They would bounce back and forth between jealousy and rage and gush. And one morning she said, okay, all right, there is this other man. And Spade totally lost it. He was more than abusive. In fact, I really am not comfortable talking about the things that he did to her. She died. He becomes indicted for murder, sentenced to, because of a heart condition, he actually didn't have the opportunity to go to San Quentin. Usually if you're convicted in California at that time of a heinous crime like this one, brutal, stomping, awful, hemorrhage from the aorta sort of death, you go to San Quentin and suffer. He went to Napa Valley. He went to Vacaville, just east of Napa, and that's where he was. 9 years into his service to the state of California in the Gray Bar Hotel, Ronald Reagan, governor then of California, arranged for a pardon. They also arranged for him to have an interim release. The release would be, his pardon was on his 60th birthday, by the way. Ronald Reagan also arranged for an interim release for him to play a fiddling performance. He didn't know where he was going. They threw him into a limo in Vacaville, Napa, probably grabbed a good cab on the way out of town, and drove to Oakland. He didn't know where he was going. He rolled into this parking lot filled with cars in a big auditorium, and he said, "Must be wrestling tonight." And so they squired him into his little dressing room. They misspelled his name, Cooley, C-O-O-L-Y, left the E out. Call him up to the show. Chill Wills, his buddy Chill Wills, was the MC of the night. He was performing a grand old Opry spectacular for the Oakland Sheriff's Association, and there were thousands of people, and they went nuts. He played three songs, which ended the first set of the evening, and he finished it with his famous number one hit, "Shame on You," to the roar of the crowds. They just went nuts.
Shame, shame on you. Gave my heart as a token, when returned it was broken. Hide your face, shame on you, shame.
He walked off the stage, said to some of his people, "I think this could work for me." And he went into his dressing room and he died to a standing ovation.
Done me wrong and that ain't funny. Woe is me, shame on you.